Hello everybody, and welcome back to Let's Play Xanadu for the MSX. Now in the last part I showed you a little bit of level 2. I've been playing off screen a bit since then, and clearing out most of level 2. So most of the free roaming monsters are dead, most of the towers are clear. And as a result we've got quite a bit of fighter and wizard experience, and we also picked up some gold. So the first thing I want to do now is get our equipment upgraded a little bit and get our next level so we can get into level 3. Now one of the first things we want to do with our equipment is of course upgrade our magic, because we haven't done that at all so far. We're still using our newbie spell Needle. It's been doing well for us so far, especially because our experience is so high with it. We've maxed it out at 255. But from level 3 onwards it's just not going to cut it. There's a second reason why I want to upgrade my spell, and that's because we want to get a mass damage type spell this time. And if we look at the available spells list, there's a couple that are marked with Deg. So we have Needle, then we have Deg Needle, we have Mitar, and then a little bit further down we have Deg Mitar. Now the Deg versions of spells are the ones that do damage to all of your enemies at once instead of just one at a time. And we're going to be running into some creatures right now that we want to get rid of really quickly. And in that case, the Deg spell is by far your best choice. Now we could go with Deg Deluge or Deg Fire. We could just barely afford them. But the reason why I prefer to go with the Deg Mitar, which is of course a slightly cheaper version and a slightly weaker version, is because a lot of creatures resist either water or fire, and Deluge and fire are of course water and fire spells. There's not so many creatures that resist Mitar, so before we can get up to the really powerful spells, I like to skip Deluge and fire altogether and get Mitar instead. So we'll do that right now. It's pretty expensive, but it's going to be worth it. Okay, we'll equip magic, scroll. I'll hang on to the Needle spell for the moment, because sometimes you do want spells that only damage a single opponent, but most of the time we'll be using our Deg Mitar from now on, at least for the next little while. Okay, well, I'll show you how the Deg Mitar spell works in a second, but first let's go back to the King to get our level up. The reason why I'm going all the way back to the King instead of just going to a temple is because I was looking at my statistics and I've kind of neglected to upgrade agility so far. I've been focusing on strength, on magic resistance, on other stuff, which is also important. But from level 3 onwards, monsters are going to get a little bit harder to hit, so our higher agility is going to help us to keep being effective with our axe or sword or whatever we're going to be using by then. So we'll go to the King, again by dropping down this hall and pressing space as soon as the portal appears. And we'll go all the way up to the King right away. Now when you're back here you can also visit the item shop, which I showed you in I think the first video. But right for the moment I don't think I need to buy anything that I don't already have. If you consistently kill creatures with your melee weapon, you tend to pick up enough items so that you rarely if ever need to use the item store. Okay, all the way back to the King. We have a fighter level, and we should also get a wizard level, yeah. And that should be it for now, yep. So we have one level of each, which gives us 4 coins to spend. I'm gonna ignore strength, intelligence, wisdom, dexterity for the moment, and go straight for agility. Now, I don't think we need all 4 points, but 3 would be nice. Getting agility up to 35 will get us at least through level 3, and maybe even through level 4. Now we have one left, which I could spend. You know what, I was planning magic resistance, but I think instead I'm going to pick up another point in charisma. Never hurts to get cheaper equipment. Although from now on I'll probably be ignoring charisma, because we'll be using items to boost it instead, but getting it up to 110 is, I think it's worth it. So, oh, I probably should have waited buying the Mitar until I did that, but oh well. So yeah, now we'll go back into the dungeon. And I'll give you a look at how the Deg Mitar spell works, and yeah, And I think after that the first thing we'll be doing is upgrading our armor. Because our armor has been doing pretty well so far. Splint mail will get you, or bandit mail will get you. Was it splint or bandit? Which one did I have? Oh, studded even. Studded mail will get you through level 2. It's not ideal, but it'll work for most of level 2. But from level 3 up, it's going to not be enough. So that's our first. The next thing we want to have on our shopping list is improved armor. And that is the very reason why I got the Mitar spell. So yeah, like I said, level 2 is mostly clear, so we'll move straight up to level 3. And we can do that by going into this little corridor and going back and forth until the teleporter takes us through the door we need. There we go. And on to level 3. Now level 3 is a pretty interesting level, because there's a couple things we'll see for the first time here. And I'll show you one of them right away. And this is also the reason why I picked up the Dagmitar instead of a normal, more powerful spell. The reason for that is that I want to fight these guys, Beholders. And Beholders are some of the most annoying creatures you can fight in this game, because they have a very powerful magic attack, which is that red ball you keep seeing there. And they also teleport instead of just moving normally. So if you're unlucky, they'll just teleport right next to you and shoot you 3 or 4 times before you have a time to respond. So these are really annoying creatures to fight. So why am I picking these out to fight first? Well, their first spawn is kind of useless, this one, so I'll just get rid of them right away. And you can see my Dagmitar spell in action here. So I just press the spacebar and all of them get hit at the same time. And keep it pressed and it'll just keep firing until they're all dead. Now, yeah, that wasn't really worth it, but let it respawn. Here's the second one. The second spawn is actually a lot more interesting than the first one. And why is it more interesting? Because the second spawn drops a ton of gold. It's actually not quite as good as the Krakens from level 2. But it's still pretty good. And there's 6 of them, so yeah. Not quite as good. They drop 100 gold for each box. So not quite as nice as the 200 that the Krakens drop in level 2, but still worth it. 600 for just a couple of these guys. And what's even better, the third spawn drops even more. So if we let it respawn one more time. Get out of the way here and move it off screen. And there it goes, it's respawned again. Hopefully it'll come down in a second. And this time it should drop 150 gold. It hit me twice, oh well. Like I said, it can just teleport right below you and there's really nothing you can do about it. Other than take the hits and hope they don't do it again. And even more so, hope that your Mitar will take them out before they do anything else. Here we go. So not only a lot of gold, but also a lot of wizard experience, because they give you 130 experience for each kill. So that's pretty nice. And as I said, 150 gold each for these boxes. Yeah, that's a nice boost. They will respawn one more time. All the monsters respawn 4 times in total. Oh, there you go. It just did. But the fourth spawn only drops a spectacle, so it's not really worth it. I'll get that one later. Now the second creature I wanted to show you is this guy, the giant slug. And the reason I want to show you this guy is because he drops a special item. This one doesn't drop a lot of gold, but the item you get from killing it with your melee weapon is very, very useful indeed. These are some of the weaker creatures in level 3. As you can see, they only do a little bit of damage to me, even though my armor is pretty weak for this level. But they drop this thing. The purple bottle, and it's just called a bottle. And what it does is, if you use it, it doubles your charisma for a short amount of time. And as you know, charisma affects the price of items in the stores, so if you use this just before buying an expensive piece of armor, it can save you a lot of money. I'm going to ignore this guy for now because it's a little bit strong for us at the moment. I'm going to see if I can get my gold up and upgrade my armor before anything else. But yeah, I'm coming up on my time limit, so I'll show you that in the next part. Thanks for watching, guys. See you then.